start again. Next talk is by Ivan Martino from Fribourg University. Title is Subspace Arrangements of a Finite Group.
Thank you so much, first of all, for being here. Because it's very late, and thank you to the organizer for letting me back here. Okay, today I would like to introduce a type of subspace arrangement coming from a group, and I first would like to give you the idea that where this kind of generalization will come. Okay, so. Okay, so let's consider W the finite group. And let's consider also a representation of it, a Pfeiffer representation. W acts naturally on Cn, and if
so, not necessary a reflection group, but just any group.
Just any group.
Okay.
I'm defining it.
Okay.
So W is a reflection, and I just discovered. I mean, it's also called a bit of pseudo reflection. If it fits codimension one subspaces. Okay, then I set these codimension one subspaces with this notation. It's a bit different with the normal one. I will be soon clear why I'm using this notation. So this is the V, the vector space, and omega is the reflection. Okay? Then, if omega is generated by reflection, then omega is a complex reflection, okay, CRG. Now, in this situation, people in literature define this object. This is the arrangement of this algebra. Okay. Well, and what people also study in general is so the open part of this arrangement is actually V minus the unit of reflection of this. So people study the complement of this for topological reason, essentially. And one which part, for instance, is that the cis that we put 2006, 2015 experiments prove that the complement for any complex reflection group is k by 1. We will be back to this in a few seconds. Okay, there is one fact I want to stress, first of all, is that this definition strongly depends on the representation, as you mentioned at the beginning. And let me give you a few examples we carry over Okay, so the first example is cell 2 inside the C-star, and I just consider a loop 1, GL channel. So we send the identity, the element in -1 C-star, and this means that we have C, and what the group fix is just the origin. So this is fix. And we have another example. Let's sum Z2 inside the GL. C, and this sign is that -1, -2, -1. So we are in C2, and around here, switch X, so the entire line is fixed by Z. Third example is that we send Z2 inside of GL2C again, but this time -1 is sent to -1, -1. So the case that in C2,
Ivan,
yes,
si possono accendere le luci della lavagna.
Prova.
Posso dare la
It possible. And here we send this one to this. So this is the in this case, of course, the group just fits the origin. Now, in the first two cases, the representation give a concentration group, and the third one, no, because this is not coordination one. So these three examples would be my little toy to play with the new definition I want to give you. But so this also give you a fact that we have a definition that does not really depend on the group, but really strongly depend on the representation. And the second point is that basis in this proof of being 2 by 1 strongly used not just this structure but also use the action of the group on the open part. So there are two means that tell us that maybe we can adjust a bit the definition. And this is what I want to do now. So from now on, let me consider B faithful. Representation of G. And for you in this talk, you can imagine that B is a complex vector space, but this is way more general. Okay? And let me consider them G inside of GLB. And of course, the group acts naturally in B. And I want to just set this stabilizer for element B. It's just the element of the group, such that the action fits. And then we give you the main definitions. So this is a subset of B such that stabilizer contain H. So H here is a subgroup. So, of course, if we just set the previous setting with a compressor virtual, with a reflection essentially, we get the same things. Okay? But, so this, so we consider all the vectors we have in this space such that the stabilizer is exactly H. So, one. You know, just with this, I have to switch my code because I'm not easy. Okay, two, let's say a few facts about this. First fact is that this is normally open. Okay? It's a variety, it's nothing more subspaces. These are subspaces. Okay? Mm-hmm. And they are a good, very good stratification of the vector space. In particular, when this vector space is just the union of this H of the subgroup G, and our root stratification, because if we set the closure of this open strata, then we get back the same subspace. And this is actually, no, it's not something more, sorry, union of the subgroup containing H. So it's union or the stratification. Okay, then I want to give a definition and some example after that. So the definition is the following. A subgroup H is a stabilizer subgroup. This open strata is non-empty. I have a few examples needed about this, just to start digesting these definitions. But let me say that this is actually something that appeared in literature some years ago, in particular in 1965, and again in 2009. Sir studied this kind of problem, this is VH, this kind of problem, but not for the complex group, but for P group. And this is the field for 5 fields. And you just try to study the problem VH being or not being empty or not. Okay? He has his own reason for that. And the second point is that using this definition, we can define a new arrangement of subspaces in these cases. So, and this is actually this for any group now. And this is exactly this. So the arrangement of the closed subspaces. For H stabilizer subgroup. It's time for examples, please. First, let me start with example. All the setup is clear. Okay. My point is that this new arrangement keeps a lot of information about the group and is way more useful than just a simple reflection arrangement, because you can choose your faithful representation. Okay? In particular, if let's set GD as a reflection rule, complex reflection rule, and we set the representation being, so G inside of GLB, as reflection rule. Okay? So this is everything as before. And then we set exactly the same setting and we get back exactly the same object, philosophically, let's say. So I will write here that our AEG is philosophically the same as before. Philosophically in the sense that the previous structure gives all the information back as we generalize it. So the example I want to show you here is the example of the S4. If this was S4, so it's a messy diagram for the lattice of subgroups of S4. And I'm fixing for each subgroup what they fix. Okay? And then what you get back is what you can imagine. That is the arrangement for S4. Very quick, because you know everything about that. So here is the origin. This is just a cut of these arrangements. So you have all the planes that you imagine, that here are just lines, but more in AG, in the new arrangement, you have also the intersections. But of course you can get back this information even from the previous structure. So here, philosophically, everything is the same. The only new things is that we keep track of the intersections. But this is nothing really new, okay? The point is that already for the always G complex reflection, but for another representation, so G inside of GLB, not a reflection representation, meaning that in this case G is not generated by complex reflections, okay? So in this case, the previous AW does not exist. And instead, this object does. Okay? So here's the first difference. Doesn't exist. It's clear this step. So here, they are philosophically the same. Here we have just more intersections. Here, this you cannot construct it anymore because you don't have just either planes. You have something else. And here we keep track of the something else. Okay?
What do you mean you have something else?
So when we had a representation that gives us the generators of reflections, then for each reflection you give back an hyperplane and you construct your arrangement. Here each reflection is not anymore a reflection. Can be something else.
Okay, it's like the third example that you have shown.
Exactly, it's exactly like the third example. What about the other cases? This is where I want to be. Yes?
You are working here for a group in general, or you are. So, you have G, and if you take a representation of G, it's a complex reflection group. If you take another representation, maybe not.
Yes.
Okay. The question is, what if G is a group such that does not exist any representation for which is...
Yes, that's my new example, yes.
It makes
also makes absolutely also sense. This is what I want to show you now. So just let me give you some example of this as we could just consider. So before we have just one hyperplane, in this case, same hyperplane, just we blew up the dimension. here the AW doesn't exist, but do exist AG as a point. Okay? So let me keep this as an example. So to show you some more interesting example different from that too, I show something in good taste. Here's the field of the difference. So my first example is actually so example of a group that is not called the convection group. First is C3, semi-dear product C3. Okay? So we can play with this, maybe not with entire things, but we can keep track of this object, this. And these are a faithful, irreducible representation. So it's inside A. It's also reducible. Inside of GDL3C. And we give you the representations of 1, F2, F3, the generators for each C3, and we send F1 to 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, F2 and F3, respectively to 1, C squared, and C. Okay? And using this, I produce AG now. The lattice of subgroup, this object is the following. We have G, we have an identity, we have three classes. We call it as the classes of subgroups, three elements each. These are sort of the three. In the middle, we have something generated by the F3. Here, we have something generated by F3, one, F3, blah, blah, F3, blah, blah, F3, blah, blah. This won't be important, but things is that they follow this. And in the middle, it's just a richness. Okay? These are the important class. Here we have, for instance, the class generated by F1. By F1 times F3. F1 times F3 squared. This class, each element of this class, fits a line. Here, fits a line. We can consider, so we pick F1, F1 is this matrix, of course, x, x1 equal x2 equal x3. Okay? And if you multiply with F2 and F2, with F3 and F3 squared, x, is the same. Let me skip this for a second. So here we have the plus F2, and F2 times. By those. They also fix a line. So a line each. Now the line is complex, so the equation is messy. And the same here for F1, F2 squared, the same multiplied by F3 and F2 squared. Okay? Fixes a line. Here instead, F2 squared. Each of these fix an equal plane. And then just step three already fix the origin. So this is just the origin. They contain F3. So all of them fix the origin and G fix the origin. So in blue I will mark the non-trivial, the stabilizer subgroup. So those are stabilizer, those are stabilizer, these are stabilizer, those are stabilizer, those are stabilizer. And then F3 fix the origin exactly as this, 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 and this. So these are stabilizer. I will show you now. Okay. So in this case, we get the following arrangements. We get exactly. So AG is 9 lines, 3 planes, the origin. Okay? And I'm always don't consider what is stabilized by E. Just because it's trivial, it's the entire space, okay? And this is strongly different by the reflection pieces. Okay? They are no more just co-dimension one object. And the other example we can make, we just sketch the built in the end, is C7 summing the recording C3. The lattice is way simpler here. That's the group. The subgroup generated by G. C7 C3. And here we get 7 subgroup, each made by A e to the R. For I go from 0 to 6. So these are order 3, these are order 7, here we get, in this case, AG is just 7 lines, and the origin of course. Each line coming from these subgroups. And stabilizer subgroup will be G, this object, and G.
What's the Pfeiffer representation?
Sorry?
What's the Pfeiffer?
Yes, I was very quick on this. So we send A to the same amount as before, so 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. And B send to C, C squared, C4. Where C to the 7 is equal to 1. And here, C to the 4 is equal to 1. Okay?
So is it though in this case if the complement is k by 1?
I will come back to the details.
Okay.
Okay, so those are two examples. Okay? No, completely different case with respect to reflection pieces. And why I'm introducing this to you? Of course, this is the main question. Let me draw a picture of the possible application of this, and then let me just restrict to one of them, just to be more precise. Okay. So we have this AEG, so arrangement. Subspaces pH for Q. So, as Professor Tavetti say, exactly we have first clear application is coming back to the basis problem. So I invite for everybody. Basis 2006-2013. And of course, the study of MHH. So it is not clear a priori to escape and one. That's the answer. But, so that everything that was already here can be applied here, very generally now. So one should be careful, maybe something else can happen, but at least the methodology is the same. Because we did nothing else, essentially. And what is MAG in this case? This is by definition, as you say, is V of the identity. Nothing else. As was in the previous case. And the previous case was the complement of something, it is VP. And if you apply the same definition to what we used before, it's always V of the identity. So this is an object that is encoded in the stratification now. So for this reason, the structure should be there. Second application is the method out. Work of 2009, where it's clear how we can use this arrangement to compute with each class of the classifying stack. VG of the group. So there is more than one person that pointed that this is possible. Fusikotaro, Bayer, and Grenoble. And this is somehow the geometric application, the topological one, it's a more geometrical one. And then in the corner, but not really in the corner, there is this. There is another problem. A very old problem starting in the beginning of the century that is essentially asking about the rationality of the quotient of the regular representation. So you consider regular representation, you quotient by the group, and then you ask, an editor is asking about the rationality of this representation for any field and for any group. She never conjectured that this was always rational, but a lot of examples were pointing that this was always rational. And then was a great counterexample coming from Swan. In 1969, saying that this was not rational. For a very specific case, it was Z of 47 in the field, the rationals. So it was a very crazy case. And then this was the algebra, so the number theory, if you want, approach. Then there was more algebraic approach by Bogomolov, by Saltman, and geometric attack was from Hecke. And essentially, so this is exactly this other. So there are some applications, I mean, at least clear to me. I won't dare to go into that, but at least this is possible. It's connected. I would like to show you this application, just for a very stupid example of that, too.
Yeah.
The three examples, and I will compute very briefly these Modlevich invariants, and I will show you that with this AG in the generalized form, with this arrangement, everything matches perfectly. So we really don't care about the representation as should be. If you are computing something, we need to have the representation. I will be very quick on this because it's a very abstract computation, but it makes sense to show it at this point. So I repeat, we have Z2 inside of C star, this picture, this is the fixed point, and we have Z2 inside C and T2C. Well, this is the fixed point. And then we have and then we have Z2 inside of ZL2C, where the fixed point is just this one. Sorry for the distinction of color. And again, what we get, so this Modivich class is a particular Euler characteristic, a generalization of the Euler characteristic of a particular object. And this lives in a ring, it's a rotative ring, but it's essentially the ring of generalized Euler characteristic. So what we get is that, so this class of Z2 is in this case equal to, now we just compute something very quick. So this is, T is like the Euler polynomial, and practically computing a generalization of the Euler polynomial, of the Poincaré polynomial. So T, because T is the, to the 1, because 1 is the dimension of this representation. And then this is equal to C star over Z2.
So I'm not sure if I well understood. You are saying that it's like a Poincaré polynomial with coefficient into the Grothendieck ring in some sense?
Yes, it's a kind of, it's almost like that.
Okay.
I don't want to be precise because people would escape with like cartoon print on the wall.
Okay.
Because it's very abstract, it's really wrong to be doing that. It's just to show you that there is an application. So the class of this object, this is a class, again the class of Z2 times the order of this fixed form. This is even this case. So if you don't for you, this is kind of I repeat almost the same computation twice and three times. But the important thing is that since this is a complex reflection, it is isomorphic to just the class of C star. And the Poincaré polynomial C star is T minus 1. This is 1. And I'm just moving this on the other side of the computation. So I will get the class of Z2, T minus 1. Equal to t minus 1. Okay? So this is saying that if this is a non-zero divisor, I can simplify, and the class of this is just 3. This will be the case. I won't prove anything, but this will be the case in this case. Let's try to do the same computation here again. So again, the class Z2 times e to the dimension of this object is 2. Then is equal to the class of C star, C2 minus a line. I'm removing the entire line that I fix. And then I get plus class of Z2 times the dimension of what is fixed. This is exactly P to the 1. Before it was 0 because I was fixing a point, now it's 1 because I'm fixing a line. Now, C2 minus a line, so C2 minus this line, is barely C times C star minus the line, so minus the point. So the Poincaré polynomial is very easy again in this case, and this is P minus 1. I move this component where there is the class of Z2 on the other side, and I will get class of Z2, T, T minus 1, equal to T, T minus 1. again, if this is a non-zero divisor, I can simplify, and I get the class of Z2 is the same.
So the moral is that you can compute some fancy invariants of the group by using the arrangement.
Yes, and here, okay, what I will get is exactly the same computation, where in the end, I will get CL Z2, T squared minus 1, in this case, because there is just one fixed point, equal to T squared minus 1. This is a very toy problem, okay? I'm not doing fancy computing seeds at the class of Z2. But the point is that for a user group, this is a way non-trivial problem. And you can choose your representation, not the reflection one. So you choose your representation, the one you like, you try to compute this, and you will get in the end that this AG, so this arranger, really compute you this invariant explicitly. There is a theorem, I don't want to speak theorem, but give you explicitly just by combinatoric the class of the Matisse class of this invariant. Okay, so let me finish with a nice phrase in the sense that there was for sure a number theory approach that had a problem. The algebra one was very strong in the end of last century. And then the geometric one is still alive, and probably this could be the combinatorial approach. Thank you.
Any questions?
In order to prove that in general, so for a general arrangement, the complement is bigger, so one not only for the basic case. So at this point, and you can consider an array, and then you can consider just the free group generated by each of the iterations of the ring. It makes sense, this choice or not?
You so you can choose again, sorry.
So you have the, some planes,
okay,
and then you say, okay, I consider the free group generated by the generators and got the one for each plane.
Okay, and for which group you are playing, you are probing the escape one?
No, you want to prove that the arrangement is escape one, and you try using this group.
Maybe, I don't know. I don't see the straight connection to the to the first group. Also because you don't have only algebraic planes.
Okay.
So, if there are no other questions, let's thank you.